Chief, you want to tell us your thoughts when you saw the video of that shootout on State Street?
Well, obviously, it's concerning. It's just an example of the kind of weaponry that our officers are confronting almost nightly right now. We've got an extremely heavily armed criminal population in Milwaukee, and they have no reluctance to use those weapons.
Can you tell us an update in that case?
Well, we're making progress. Well, I can tell you right now. I think we're making a lot of progress in the number of shootings and our homicides from last weekend. So, fortunately, you know, I think we're going to be able to bring some people to justice, but that doesn't mean we're going to stop seeing this weaponry.
A lot of people who saw that video might have been surprised, even startled at seeing that kind of weapon on the streets. How common is it?
It's not uncommon. We seize, about 100 or so long guns a year out of the 3,000 or so that we take from criminals. So it's not uncommon. I mean, we use ShotSpotter, obviously, to get the crime scenes and collect evidence. We frequently find assault weapon ammunition on site, ammunition shell casings that connect to assault rifles.
A couple of brazen shooting in the middle of Main Street recently, at State Street over the weekend, and the Journal Sentinel building earlier in the month. Is this an alarming trend, perhaps? It just shows these criminals are willing to just open fire anywhere?
We're finding our career criminals are mobile. Certainly the Journal Sentinel shooting was concerning and isn't bystander hit in what appears to be a road rage incident. Heedless behavior, not uncommon to this population. And the business downtown, again, I mean, you know, we've got a vibrant nightlife that attracts, you know, people from all over the metropolitan area. And some of them come there, obviously, with attitude and weapons. And that results in the kind of video you saw.